5. Hey everybody, how are you? Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. I've got Enrique here.
Hello.
And this is Kaiser. Just having a little bit of fun. This is all fun stuff. Kaiser's a really cool dog. We're going to be doing some obedience. And we're also going to be doing some bite work. The obedience part to me is just super fun. And you're going to be able to see how hard that Enrique has been working with this dog. And there's something that he did during warm-up. I don't know if he's going to do it now, but it's called silent commands. He was actually whispering commands to his dog, and his dog was doing it. It was super, super cool. The cool thing about that is this. You know, as a family dog trainer, which is what I am, bite work is a whole other world. But the cool thing about this is, a lot of us, when our dogs are not listening to us, we raise our voices because we think our dogs are going to be listening better. But this just goes to prove when your actually dog is tuned in to you, he'll actually pay focused attention. And just wait until you see this. This is a lot of fun. Remember, this is all for fun. But yes, this dog does do bite work. But we're just going to have a little bit of fun right now. And everybody, this is just for pure enjoyment. So let's just watch. Let's just see and watch. Let's just awesome. All have fun with this.
All right, Bubba.
Ready?
All right, go back. Place. Sit. I'll start with a quick demo as far as like how fast he can do the techniques.
Okay, he's going to stay right there. So
yep.
Okay.
Guys, down. Stand. Down. Sit. Stand. Sit. Down. Stand. Down. Stand. Sit. Down. Stand. Sit. Down. Stand. Stand. Down. Stand. Sit. All right, here we go with the whispers now.
Okay, now hold on here.
Yeah,
now,
I'll wait for the whispers.
I'm going to come over here. Can you get a little bit closer to him so I can make sure he does this here? So Enrique is right here.
All the way here.
Okay, he's right here. And then he's going to look. So he's not going to use any hand signals at all. I want to get closer to the dog. But he's not going to use any, I assure you, he's whispering with no hand signals at all. So watch this. So just over here, let me see if I can assign. There we go, right there. Perfect.
Stand. And because he's watching, he's so focused, he's not going to move no matter what I do. Watch. Guard. Guard. Reverse. Reverse. Guard. Good. Reverse. 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 Good. Down.
Good job, buddy.
Come here, buddy. Sit. Sit. front, down, reverse. We got four toys.
He wasn't slapping him.
No, I was stupid.
No. Get over it real quick. This is a dog that would break through a brick wall.
Who said that? Somebody. So this is a pretty awesome focus exercise because all the toys he's gonna want.
Right.
But I'm only gonna tell him to pick one, and I'm gonna use my hands to kind of guide him as to which one I want him to get.
Got it. Want to start slow?
Front, place.
Okay, well, being a dick is not a reason to be on my Periscope.
So. Was that?
We're all set.
Oh. All right. Now I'm gonna do the left one. Kaiser. Over, place. Down. Front. Back. Sit. Out. Sit. Over, place. Good. Out. Place. Sit. Good. Front. Place. Fetch, out, fetch, sit, out, over, fetch, sit, front, out, nice, back, fetch, front, out, sit, out, out, back, fetch, front, front, out, there you go. All gathered, ready to go.
Thanks.
Yeah.
How long have you had the dog for?
almost 4 years. Four or five years.
So, what was the hardest thing that you trained?
Honestly, the basics. Because the basics, you have to keep them up all the time. You know, you start getting focused on the trick training, right, and then you forget the basics, and then the tricks go away.
Right.
So it's gotta be maintained.
So something like reverse, how long does it typically take a dog to reverse, like 20 feet?
It really depends. Right. Like, Malinois are pretty good dogs that learn pretty quickly, so it's really the breed that depends on it.
Yeah.
There's some dogs that just want me to learn, you know?
Yeah.
Just like I can't learn math to save my life, you know?
Right.
No matter what I do.
Right. All right. Do you want to give yourself a plug? How do people get a hold of you?
Dogworks, D-O-G-W-O-R-X. You can look me up on Facebook.
Yep.
And you'll find me.
So Dogworks, great. And is every breed of dog capable of doing this?
No.
Okay.
No. You really have to kind of see what your dog is capable of and not capable of.
Got it.
There are some dogs that are doing really amazing stuff. Like with him, ironically, he can't climb things pretty high.
Okay.
So really high jumps, he won't be able to do them.
Okay.
So I'd rather focus on things that he can do better.
Got it. And then when he did that look, like when you got him to look at something, mm-hmm. What did you call it, stare? Or
Watch.
And you got him to watch something and then you were moving around his back end and he wouldn't take the focus mm-hmm. off. Is that something you start like, just how do you get him to like watch whatever you point at?
Cool, I'll show you quick. Come here, buddy. So the dog is supposed to already know place.
Got it.
So basically I put like a little cot. Come here, buddy. Out. Come. Out. Heel. Sit. So let's pretend this is a cot already and I have this.
Yes.
So I use kind of like a timing method. So I make sure that the dog is following it. So when I throw it, the moment he looks, I give the cue watch. Watch. And little by little, he knows that whenever I say watch, he's gonna watch whatever I'm pointing at.
Got it.
Heel.
And he always is gonna be rewarded with what he's watching at,
yeah,
right?
Heel, watch, yeah, yes. At the beginning, and eventually I start winging that out. That way he doesn't anticipate that and just goes for it.
Got it.
Heel. Heel. Watch. Heel. Watch. Heel. Heel. Right side. Takes lots of little repetitions, and you don't have to say the watch whatever word you want to use as long as you use the same word every time.
Right.
Like it's the best way to do it.
Right. Awesome. This dog works with an X though, right?
Yes.
Guys, what I'll do is this. This Periscope, also, we're also on Facebook Live. We're going to, in the description, we'll put Enrique's contact information. All right? And do you do any sport training or are you doing this for fun?
This is just for fun for me. My majority of stuff I do, like Jeff does, you know, behavior right. modification.
So you're not belonging to any sport clubs or anything like that?
Not right now.
You just do like, this is just fun.
This is fun, yeah.
This is fun. This is like, just a really damn good hobby for you.
Yeah, I love it.
Awesome. Awesome. Right? Is this for police dogs? Actually, police dogs, they don't want this, no. A police dog probably doesn't know 90% of this stuff at all. Mm-hmm. They really don't need to. Like, police dogs don't need to know this stuff. They just need to know to track and to track and to bite, and they don't need to be, I don't want to say as impulse controlled. It'd be nice if they were, but that's not what they need, you know?
And so. Also it takes a very long time. You know, like with him I can be like 4 or 5 hours training.
Right.
And obviously, you know, right. Gentlemen in the police department have other tasks to do.
Exactly.
So they have to
exactly.
prioritize.
Right. Awesome. Any other questions? How do you teach the guard? The guard was when he went to the object and
barking. Yeah. Yep. So I first had to teach him how to bark and command.
Yes.
Once I taught him how to bark and command, what I did is I held a specific toy, for example, and I said, bark when he was barking. Then I said, guard, and I gave him the toy. So I was basically removing the bark command and turning it into a guard command.
Got it.
And then once he started getting the gist of it, then I was doing what the watch place, yes. The watch situation. I threw it and I said guard, and he immediately knew what to do because
right.
he was already used to the guard command.
Got it. Those aren't bags. These are all bikes. It's okay to
yeah.
touch whatever he's in his mouth.
No.
So this is a tug. This is just a standard tug. Okay? This is a standard tug. He's got an arm sleeve right now. So he's got a bike sleeve right now. This is a standard tug. So these two are tugs. There's nothing in these. This is a tongue, this is a tongue, and this is a bite sleeve as well. What's inside of it? Padding. Just padding. They're padding. That's it. There's nothing inside of them at all. The dog's not biting it because there's like peanut butter inside. They're biting it because they like the bite. It's fun to play tongue. Tongue is actually, a lot of people will say, oh, tongue is not good for aggressive dogs. Actually, controlled biting is not good for aggressive dogs. So we saw this dog doing a lot of controlled biting. So as far as walking backwards, did we videotape you teaching Kara how to walk backwards or a girl how to walk backwards?
We'll do it today after this.
We're going to do a small videotape. You already did or no?
No, we didn't videotape it. We just
okay. We'll videotape one of my dogs who does not know how to do backwards walking. So you saw Kaiser do probably about 20 steps backwards. You're going to learn how a dog starts with one step.
Yes.
So you'll do that. We'll do a video on that. How long did this training take? It's probably been ongoing for 4 years, but like a year in the training, could you have done this, or was there still
no? I mean, it also really depends a lot of the dog. Like I was super blessed to get an awesome dog.
Got it.
There's some dogs that's gonna take you a long time, and some dogs.
So no matter what your skill set is as a trainer, the dog obviously has a lot to do.
As a dog, honestly, right. Like I'm an average trainer.
Yes.
He's the one with the talent.
He's the one with the skills.
Think of it as like a basketball team. You know, the coach is awesome, but if LeBron James and those people leave, then
exactly. You know? So I know LeBron James has the same coach as the not so greatest player on the team.
Exactly.
Same
coach. Really, it's just teamwork.
Got
really
it.
What it comes out
Got
to.
It. Right. And bite work. How do you train a dog to bite? What's the basics of bite work?
So it starts super early in life. The bite work is not out of aggression, it's out of play. I teach the dog that tugging on a toy is fun.
So you start with prey tugs?
Yes. Yeah, very, very little. Like when they're little, we use like a
fork pole.
Fork pole with tied up with a rope,
yep.
With a like a little mantle, and they follow it along.
Yep.
Because Malinois do have what we call prey drive. They chase little critters, they're more apt to it. And then the same cloth material that the towel is made of, what the bite suits and sleeves are made out of.
Right.
So they understand, hey, this is bite, this is play, and then you start graduating to more different things.
Yeah, right. Are there drugs for mental stability? More training. You don't need a drug you don't need a drug to make your dog better. You just need to keep your dog, just do more of this every day. Just do more of this every day. Yep. All right, any other questions before we sign off?
Facebook Live. Yep.
Anything else?
Thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it.
Awesome. Great job. Thanks for demoing it. Thanks. Right. All right. Are they good for small breeds? You know, this is the thing about a Malinois. You know, it's we're going to plug this. Don't worry. We'll put it. It's dog. What's spell out your website
it's
again?
Okay. www.dogworx.com. .us.
.us. Sorry.
Yeah.
So dog. Works with an X, .us. So this is the thing about a male. I probably would not get a male as a family dog. That does not mean it can't be, but I would not. Every once in a while, put it this way, I don't know a ton of males. I probably know 100 collies with males, and I know two that would be safe with families. And one of those has to be highly monitored, and the other one is just literally like a bulldog couch potato, which is almost unheard of as far as males. I would not get a male as a family dog. That doesn't mean it can't be, but it's just not advised. It's not advised.
Now, the way I think about dogs, and I hate to kind of materialize it, is the cars. Right. If you're an off-road kind of person, you're not going to get a Toyota Prius.
Right.
Don't. And if you want to be on the road and save gas, you're not going to get a pickup truck. So you have to pick what is it that you want your car for. Same thing. What do you want your dog for? I wanted a dog to really pour all that I know into him.
Yeah.
If you want a dog to chill on the couch, then you know, get chewy.
Exactly. They're not good for families because number one, most families can't raise a low energy dog. Seriously. Most families cannot raise, I'm sorry, but most families, I mean, this is what we do all the time. Most families are struggling with just your basic average energy dog that needs 30 minutes of exercise a day. A male, it's a high drive dog. That's like giving your 16-year-old a Ferrari. Sorry, it's just pretty much what it is. It takes a skill set of a human being, and it takes a lifestyle of a human being to keep these dogs safe. So.
And it's everyday training. I mean, it doesn't stop.
Exactly. All right. Awesome. Thanks a lot, Enrique.
Thank you.